Community, the European Union is a great community to do things, to get things done. It can also be a great community not to get things done, but let's think positive. The next person on stage will be Marco, who is part of the European Policy Center Task Force on Digital and Circular Economy. And we hope to actually have an interactive discussion here about what the European Union, the Commission, should be doing in that space to actually drive action.
Okay, well, thank you, Michael. Really my big pleasure to be here. Well, it's our home base, so I'm here pretty much every day, and that you are here. My role today is actually to pass on a message, or several messages, from a group that I've been working with, which is the task force that Michael mentioned. And I'd like to just to get your input as well. Is this sensible? Is this what European Union should be doing? And I'm going to divide this maybe 15, 20 minutes that I have into two parts. First, I'll just go very briefly some of the current thinking in the task force to give you kind of the snapshot of what the work is about and what the current ideas, the recommendation drafts could be. And then I would like to turn it around and actually you to discuss pairwise with the person next to you or whomever you want to talk to, and then report back. So take out your laptops or mobile phones while I'm speaking. So we'll use a system to collect your input for, let's say, the other 10 minutes that we are on this. So yes, indeed. So I have two different roles. I'm an adjunct professor at Aalto. This work is more connected to my role at Aalto than the work that I'm doing here in this building, which is the EIT digital side. But definitely, of course, EIT is a European institution as well. So this EPC work started this year, will continue next week, next year. So the European Policy Center is one of these organizations that try to influence what Commission is doing. So they identified that an interesting combo is this digital and circular economy. So what should Europe do in this space? And then, therefore, this task force was formed. From Finland, there are actually three partners in this. So Aalto is there, the Helsinki EU office in Brussels is there, and also Luke. And maybe some of this has already been discussed in this digital circular discussions while I wasn't actually present, by Luke earlier. But still kind of a very brief where the work is now. So first of all, what does this group think that this combo of digital and circular is all about? So then these eight titles sort of capture that. And I won't go into details. I'm, you know, more than happy to share you the slides later on. But these are the kind of the eight areas that have been kind of sketched, that what could be, what do we mean when we combine these two different topics, digital and circular? So again, I will not go into the details of this list. And several of these topics have been, you know, touched in the previous sessions of Digitally Circular and will be touched in the future session we've got. However, okay, so at the very high level, the point is that European Union should have a vision, should have a statement that why this combination is important. And first of all, so, well, we have both old technologies, we can build new technologies, but the link between digital technologies and sustainability is not evident. So the point here is that yes, if you combine those two, so you can have more sustainable business models, yes, you can make businesses that actually thrive because of the better combination. And then the last point is that it looks like that unlocking different different ways of how people are currently not using data across different organizations. And this goes very much back to what Karolina was just saying. So kind of how do we unlock the value of data, of information? So that seems to be one of the keys. And what could European Union do in that particular area? So anyway, so this is a draft, very high level draft. Okay, so then I'll go briefly, and I've picked these five things as highlights myself. So this is ongoing work. The steering group of this has not really discussed this yet, so I'm sharing this with you while this sort of draft is just being shown to the steering group next Friday. But I just want to get your feedback. So first of all, the thing that seems evident, but it's not evident at all, is the funding for this combination. So here the proposal is that there is a new program that's supposed to be starting in 2021 in the new Horizon Europe program called Digital Europe. So we should put aside specific funds from that particular program for this combination of sustainability and digitalization. So I think that's the key message here, this point number two. So it's a 9.2 billion that are planned for this Digital Europe program alone in Horizon Europe. And at the moment, I don't think that in that program there is anything reserved for this combo. And that's the statement that this team is now making. There are other instruments as well listed here that could be similarly effective with the same message. So it's not Digital Europe alone, but that seems to be the right place. Then there are some prioritizations of which industry should be the first, but I mean, why not logistics? I'm sure that would be as important than the four ones that are listed here. The second one, and again, I think this will be very controversial in a way if it's going to be proposed, but it's a pretty bold idea. Well, actually, it should be digital product or material passport, not a material passport. But anyway, so the idea that EU would have a structure that products and the materials used in product should be better available in digital form. So kind of standardized way of having the record of which materials have been used in any given product. And of course, this is going to be thorny because there's IP involved. And what are the incentives for companies to do such a thing? You can get fairly far with regulation, but then not all of it should be regulated. So anyway, so that's going to be a problematic thing to get going. But on the other hand, it could be a huge opportunity for Europe if something like could be done. And then there was specific discussion of what can we learn from the chemical side of this, because that has been regulated for a long time, and so forth. The third thing, and this goes directly to what we just heard from Cargotec. So how do you incentivize organizations, not only to do the thing that I just mentioned about the passport, but in general, to share data more? What are the mechanisms to provide ways in which companies can be more effective in sharing data? And maybe the Commission could have a role in that. Specific standards to help in doing that. And also this question that who should control these platforms? How could be sort of, what are the intermediaries that are needed? So maybe European Commission could be there to kind of, incentivize the companies to look for these structures that work for them. But anyway, so this is the third point. So data sharing, how that can be improved to foster circular economy. The fourth one is digital and circular public procurement. So, first of all, the ways how procurement is done should be more digital, should be more effective, and that can be guided. There can be best practices for that. But then, how in the procurement processes these different questions of is this combination of digitalization and sustainability / circular economy, have these been well thought through? So that should be part of any procurement processes on the public sector side. And then the last point, the fifth point, is informing and empowering citizens to be better aware of different, you know, impacts of their everyday choices, and helping with digital means to make more sustainable choices in everyday life. And then there is this idea also of kind of this, you know, shared responsibility. So it's not only that citizens are kind of consuming information, but they also can take responsibility in several ways in terms of being an active actor in the economy, and then how do you empower people to do that. So this is a really broad set of issues here as well. All of these five are actually quite broad. Some may be kind of more specific, here's the funding, some may be more specific on, okay, let's do procurement, but all of these ideas are fairly broad. So this is a quick run through. Now, the next thing to do is, I like to engage all of you, your input. You just heard five things that I mentioned about what the European Commission could be doing. So why don't you go to this particular website called presemo.alta.fi/dcircular, and we'll do the interactive part. So here's the address once more. So presemo.alta.fi/dcircular. And when you go in there, so you should see my first question there already visible.
I don't see there anything.
Okay.
Maybe it's just me because I have an ad blocker, but I don't see there anything.
It works for me as well.
It works.
I have no idea whether this one is influenced by ad blockers. I don't know. But how many of you see the first question? Okay, very good. Now, answer the first question from your own perspective. So there are five different options, five different incentives, recommendation drafts. So which ones of you, those you would rate as most interesting or important? Maximum three. No, you don't need to submit anything, just click. Okay, so without taking more time, so this was a sort of a, you know, warm-up thing so that you're in the system. But the real thing is that why don't you now find a pair, or maybe it's a three of you, but start discussing the things that I just mentioned, and imagine that you have, you know, virtual post-it notes. So the things that come to your mind as the most important things, things that you are concerned about, why is this a good idea? Why are these bad ideas? What should be thought of instead? So write them down on the next thing that I'm going to put up there, which is this one. So now you should see a sort of a chat box out there. So discuss with the person next to you or persons next to you and document what you have discussed on this screen. So I'll give you how many minutes, Michael? 5 minutes. So 5 minutes for discussion. Go. Okay. Now, thank you for all of your input. I hope you had good discussion. The next thing to do, and we don't have much time, so I will just highlight a few things that you spoke about in your group, but all of the comments that you had definitely will be fed back to you, and we might get back to some of these also in the panel discussion that will follow soon. Just before we go to what you just wrote, so of the five areas, so it looks like that it's fairly uneven. Maybe, well, Caroline and myself did a bit of an advertisement for this data sharing site, but that was the number one. Then the financial support, which obviously is important, and empowering and informing the citizens pretty much next. And interestingly, well, the passport, sure, but the procurement side doesn't seem to interest people that much. Anyway, so going to your feedback. So, and again, on the web, you can, on the interface that you just used, so you see everybody's input yourself. But I'm just going to highlight here a few ones that the question of whose data, how much are we going to use individuals' data, what kinds of financial models there are behind to make these systems work, both very important points. GDPR actually has been discussed a fair bit in the group. And this whole combo of, you know, yes, we will have a lot of industrial data, but then if you are talking about everyday behavior of people, so then inevitably you're going to have a lot of individual data as well. So the combination is really important. And the question of privacy seems to be several comments. And another one that I like about this sort of the last point, the citizen engagement. So you need to give incentives not only to the organizations, which was a little bit what I mentioned there in terms of funding, in terms of like, why would you share, but also incentives for individuals. What's in it for them? Obviously, hopefully a more sustainable world, but other incentives as well. How do you figure them out? I think we are out of time, actually. So this was an exercise. Really, really big thanks for everybody for participating, and we will share this back with you as much as possible. Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you, Marco.